Another addition to my American War of Independence collection, largely aimed at sharp practice too, are these Royal Welsh Fusiliers that I completed painting a little bit of time ago, actually. I think I'd completed them before I started the American Indians that I showcased in the other video, but they've been sat around neglected in the sense that they weren't based, because I thought that I would finish the next batch of miniatures for this collection much, much sooner, and thus I could base them all together. So they've been sitting around in that sense, unready for action, but they've now been based alongside with the American Indians that you saw in the other video, and here they are completed. It's just a brief look at them. These are, as is my preference, 28mm metal figures from Perry Miniatures. I think there is some debate about some of the uniform detail and research that went into creating these, but I'm not really bothered by that, if I'm completely honest. I quite like the figures, and they're sort of distinct from other uniform designs in the range that I've included in the collection already. And they were pretty straightforward to paint because they've got the cut down jackets and so on. The only thing I will say is that my red mixture in this case, I think, came out a little bit darker than usual. And it's one of those things where I didn't necessarily realize that was the case until I had finished painting the other details, which tend to make the red look brighter because the amount of white around them. But I enjoy painting them. I like the aesthetics. I particularly enjoy the sort of skirmishing firing line packs that Perry do because of the variation in poses and the dynamism they get into them. Even though some of these packs are, I mean, you're getting on a little bit in years now, they're still very nice miniatures. And these didn't require, unlike others that I have bought from Perry in the past, a great deal of cleanup either. They were pretty straightforward to get ready and primed, and then the painting time was pretty quick because, like I say, it's basically red, white and grey that went into these. I think the greatest period of time went into the details like the flesh and some of the brass fittings on the muskets. So yeah, that's another addition to the British side of my force. I really need to start working on the American side of things to balance it out, which I think I'll probably do with some riflemen next, and also I've got some Stockbridge Indians that I want to add to them. But these should hopefully be coming to an action on the tabletop in the very near future, as I want to get a few of these new miniatures out and give them a roll across the table. And by that, I probably mean getting absolutely massacred in their first engagement. So I hope you've enjoyed having a quick look at these and look forward to seeing them on the tabletop soon. If you have any questions about them, please let me know in the comments below. And in the meantime, happy hobbying.